everyone, namaste. Welcome to the new episode of the Human Health and the Disease. In the last episode, we have talked about the sulfonylurea. So today we will see about the alpha glucosidase inhibitors. So commonly used drug under this category is acarbose. So let's see about it. Acarbose is also recommended for the hypoglycemia treatment. It targets the postprandial glucose peak. Moreover, acarbose is taken orally and it affects the untaken glucose from your intestine. Physiologically, the carbohydrate complex present in your lumen of the small intestine are broken by the enzyme named as the alpha glucosidase before the glucose molecules are taken up and reach to the bloodstream. Finally, when you give the acarbose, in that time it compete with the carbohydrate complex and bind with the alpha glucosidase. As the result, the carbohydrate complex remains intact and it causes the reduction in your glucose level. In this way, alpha glucosidase inhibitors acarbose delay the absorption of carbohydrate in the gastrointestinal tract and effectively reduce the postprandial glucose plasma level. Let's see the benefits of it. So it delay your diabetes mellitus progression and it shows the benefit with the cardiovascular disease. In diabetes condition, the postprandial peak glucose level also affects the blood vessels. In the prolonged hypoglycemia condition, it causes the thickening of the blood vessel wall. There are the wide study which suggests that acarbose also help in the reduction of the atherosclerosis and also in the reduction of the other intramural vascular effects. Diabetes mellitus also associated with the high blood pressure, or you can say the hypertension. Atherosclerosis and hypertension are the major consequences for the cardiovascular disease. It also develops the coronary artery disease and the myocardial infarction. By reducing the hypertension and the other ventromedial vascular effect, acarbose also reduces the acute myocardial infarction event. In this way, it also helps to prevent the cardiovascular events in the type 2 diabetes mellitus. Acarbose is having the unique kind of the mode of action where it shifts the glucose from the upper to the lower intestine. So it causes the gastrointestinal side effect. So normally if you have to reduce it, normally the doctor they have given the drug from the lower dose. Then gradually they increase, then gradually they have given to the full dose. So it will help to reduce the gastrointestinal side effect event. So guys, thank you so much for watching. This was for today and thank you so much for giving your valuable time and watching this episode. Thank you so much guys. Have a great day. Take care. God bless you all.